The first pictures of Intel's high-end Xe HPG DG2 GPU-based discrete gaming graphics card and specifications have been leaked by Moore's Law is Dead. Now, the leakers not only posted the first pictures of the engineering board, but also detailed the specifications and expected performance numbers of the flagship part. Now, going forward, we'll be referring to the Xe HPG DG2 GPU, simply the DG2. So, the DG2 is based on Gen 12 graphics architecture and is a brand new design, hence it will be expected to use some brand new shading techniques, which will be discussed in this video. Other than that, the Intel discrete graphics card will come with full support for ray tracing and a range of other capabilities, such as Intel's own DLSS competitor, which is internally being referred to as XeSS, or rather, Xe Super Sampling. As for the card itself, Moore's Law is Dead stated that the sample pictured is very early engineering sample and not a final design. This is apparent from the green colored PCB and cheap plastic shroud, which will be changed in the final version of the card. Now, the pictures show the card running in a dual slot form factor with dual fan cooling, a large aluminum fin heatsink, and the Intel logo plastered across a small acrylic panel. Note, however, the L is missing. The card features an 8+6 pin connector configuration, and Moore's Law is Dead states that the expected TDP of the Intel DG2 gaming graphics card is to be expected to be upwards of 275 watts. Now, the PCB or the back is not shown in the leak as it contains traces through which Moore's Law is Dead source could be tracked. Now, each DG2 GPU SKU will come in various configurations, which will range from the full fat chip to the several cut down variants. Now, this is similar to NVIDIA's GA102-400 and GA102-200 naming schemes, or AMD's Navi 21 XTX, XT, or XL naming conventions. Now, the top DG2 512 EU variant is just one of the configurations listed so far, and that utilizes the full die with 4096 cores, 256-bit bus interface, and up to 16 gigabytes of G6 memory. 8 gigabytes of G6 has been listed as well. Now, based on demand and yields, Intel could provide more variants of the flagship chip, but we can't say for sure right now. Now, the DG2 512 EU chip is suggested to feature clocks upwards of 2.2 gigahertz, though we don't know if these are average clocks or the maximum boost clocks, or turbo for Intel. They may use the turbo moniker. But it's also stated that Intel's initial TDP target was around 225 to 250 watts, but that has been upped to around 275 watts, and we can expect a 300 watt variant with dual 8-pin connectors too if Intel wants to push the clocks even further. Now, once again, these are just a few of several variants that will be utilizing the Xe HPG architecture. Now, the Intel DG2 GPUs will be coming to both desktop and mobility designs later this year and are rumored to be based on external foundry process nodes, most probably TSMC and its 6-nanometer node, or N6. Now, besides that, some performance targets have also been mentioned with the flagship DG2 GPU, and it's been hinted to be upwards as fast as NVIDIA's GeForce RTX 3080, which should put it close to the AMD Radeon RX 6800 XT as well. Now, the 3DMark TimeSpy scores vary a lot based on previous samples and end up somewhere between the RTX 2080 and the RTX 3090. Now, the performance metrics could simply be differently configured DG2 SKUs. Now, it's stated that the company will have a very good driver stack, but that depends on timing of the cards itself, as Intel could go one of two routes. Either push the line back for drivers to mature, or release them in early but still offering good support, but lack in terms of other features, similar to AMD's RDNA 2, which still hasn't received its DLSS competitor months after launch. Now, the encoding and prosumer capabilities are also going to be very impressive on the Xe HPG graphics cards. Now, the leaker states that the card is nowhere near ready for launch until Q4 of 2021 or even early next year for proper availability. No AIBs have received proper information about the cards yet, as the cards are still receiving design tweaks by Intel themselves. Prosumer variants are also expected, but will not be ready until 2022 for certain, and it looks like the 512 EU SKU will be headed out to the consumer segment first, followed by the 128 EU SKUs shortly after. Now, the leaker also states that the successor to the DG2 GPUs will be known as Elasti, or DG3, and has a release schedule for 2023. As for pricing, the mid-range cards are expected to be priced around $200 to $300 US, which is what Raja Koduri considers to be the sweet spot for gaming. There's no mention of pricing for the higher end variants, but expect them to be over the $500 US price point. Now expect more information around the middle of this year related to Intel's desktop discrete gaming graphics lineup. Hey guys, I want to thank you for making it to the end of this video. If you like what you've seen, make sure you hit the subscribe button down here in this corner and check out a video that you may have missed in our lineup. And we'll catch you in the next one.